Oh, gentlemen, please. We continue the program, ladies and gentlemen, with a featherweight contest of 6 3-minute rounds between introducing in the red corner, ladies and gentlemen, from Birmingham. He scaled 9 stones, 6.5 pounds. Tonight, taking part in his 152nd professional contest, Peter Buckley. And in the blue corner, ladies and gentlemen, weighing in at 9 stones, 5 pounds from Coventry, would you please welcome Richard Evatt. The officials for this contest, the referee is Mr. Phil Kane, the timekeeper is Mr. Barry Pinder, and it is 4 3-minute rounds. The referee will give his instructions to the boxers.
4 or 6?
Well, it's only an undercard fight, but it's a crucial night for Richard Evatt from Coventry, whose career has gone into a nosedive. He's lost 4 of his last 5, and this was the man who so very nearly beat the world-class Junior Jones. It's all going wrong for him. He's in here with Peter Buckley, the very well-travelled Birmingham journeyman, in his 152nd fight tonight. But Evatt, there's no doubt about it, he's in crisis. Looked to be on the verge of some pretty big things. Beaten by Isaac Sedabuka in a shock last time, had his man down in the first round, then was floored and stopped in the second. So only due to go 4 rounds, Buckley will try to mess him around and survive with that cross-arm defense and all his usual survival skills.
Well, after seeing how his career has gone, Evatt, Buckley might just fancy this a bit more now. He lost to him just a little while ago. He stopped him in the 5th round of the only fight that Evatt's won in Evatt's last 5. So Buckley, you know, may just fancy it a bit more.
He might. Let's see. Evatt in desperate need, though, of something to restore his confidence. He's almost had to go right back to the beginning, trying to rebuild his career. He's based in Belfast now. He's joined the Jerry Story team, a case that of being sent from Coventry, I guess, Glenn.
Something like that. Well, he needs to do something. He needs to change his career around, all going wrong for him. So, you know, he's tried something to... something new. So, you know, you've got to give him a pat on the back for that. At least, you know, he wants to do it.
Has to be a question about Evatt's punch resistance. Looking for some head movement. To make his pressure maybe a little more educated than we've seen in the past, but he does really pack a wallop.
I think it really is going to be difficult for him to change his style. I think, you know, the style he had was what suits him best. You know, maybe just found something, you know, chink in the chin.
Also broke his jaw against Mick O'Malley, the Australian, who was later beaten by Ian McLeod. And it wasn't too bad from Evatt. I should think he knows Peter Buckley pretty well. They're from the West Midlands, the pair of them.
Well, I think everybody knows Peter Buckley pretty well. He's on just about every show there is.
16 wins out of 20 so far, and among those defeats, that great effort he put up against Junior Jones, in the end getting stopped in 11 rounds, but he looked for a long way in that fight like the winner. It would have been a major breakthrough for him. Unfortunately, it didn't happen. and instead of huge purses and glory, he's back to square one, fighting Peter Buckley. Really is a game of snakes and ladders, this, isn't it, sometimes?
It certainly is. The snakes can be very long and the ladders very short.
Here's the second round. The spotted trunks of Richard Evatt. New style, he's called the Tiger, but has dispensed with the usual kind of tiger style haircut, which takes 2.5 hours. This time he looks to have adopted a rather more no-nonsense attitude, dispense with the gimmicks. Good body shots from Evatt.
Maybe didn't feel it was worth the 2.5 hours in the barber's chair for a little four-rounder.
Good uppercut from him as well. He'll do very well to stop Buckley, who's a renowned at just sticking around and covering up, getting through. Has stopped Buckley before, of course.
Well, he really needs just constant pressure, I think, in this fight to come through safely. Buckley not really renowned for punching power or winning, just merely a survivor, but somebody who can survive in decent company.
Just looking by the right eye of Evatt, there seems to be some minor blemish there. No cut as such at the moment, I don't think. Bit of swelling. Two decent right hands from Evatt.
Well, Evatt's trying to plant his feet and really get a bit of meat behind these punches.
All the pressure coming from him. Buckley, I think, has come in as a pretty late substitute here, but that's nothing new for him. Metaphorically speaking, he's one of those fighters who just hangs around by the phone. Some pretty meaty shots going in here, though, from Evatt.
Well, he's warming up now. He's up in his work rate, and he's starting to land more and more. Some good right hands going in.
Really is hugging the canvas, too, with his feet. Looking to get that extra leverage. Good solid jab, too. Buckley just giving the odd reminder that he's still around.
Well, Buckley needs to throw more punches because that's the only way he's going to keep Evatt off him.
Hasn't won Peter Buckley since last October against another centurion, as it were, Miguel Matthews. Had to take rather too many here, Buckley. Defense not as tight as usual. Evatt's got through with a lot. There is that damage underneath the right eye of Evatt. It's nothing for him to worry about.
Buckley needs to cover up a bit more. He's getting caught time and time again off some good, meaty-looking right hands from Evatt. And there was a better work rate in the second round from Richard. Really banging in those punches, trying to get a lot of power behind the right hand. Good uppercut there, just found the gap in the cross-arm guard of Buckley.
It would have been easy for him to drift away from the sport, really, after what happened in his last fight. Things not going his way, but he's shown character to go over to Belfast, try to get his career back on the rails, and he deserves credit for that.
He does deserve credit. That's obviously been very hard to get over those defeats and to push forward and keep trying.
So you wish him well. Third round, only due to go for this. Evatt with the reputation of being something of a rough diamond, hard character. Right. Supposed to be a rehabilitation night for Evatt, this, but so is the last fight against Isaac Sebaduka, and that didn't work out at all. And Sebaduka might have made himself a man to be avoided as a result of that.
Well, I think they picked this match, you know, to get the confidence back for Evatt, because Buckley is never dangerous.
Low blow from Evatt, keep them up, says Phil Kane. Pretty business-like the way Evatt's going about this.
Couple of nice punches going in from Evatt, just remind him from Buckley, just remind Evatt he's still there.
One thing about Evatt, at his best, he is quite an exciting fighter who could sell some tickets. You could see him getting back in the picture if he could put together a run of, say, three or four wins, with the quality of opposition improving all the time. But from where he is, it's quite a long way back.
Well, he's using his jab quite well here. It's a nice solid punch.
Just looking a bit wild with a couple of those right hands. You just telegraph them a little. Buckley saw them from several weeks away. Buckley looking a little less comfortable than I've sometimes seen him in contests of this nature. I think these are pretty hard shots that Evatt's scoring with when he does get through.
Yes, I think the jab and the right hand is really putting a bit of power in them. I think Evatt is a pretty hard puncher, you know, not just with his big ones, with most of his punches.
Mixing them up quite well to head and body. The uppercut didn't land, the right hand definitely did, and Buckley drops his gloves there, and I think he was stung by that one, no doubt about it. He's usually got the old poker player's face, Peter Buckley, but he didn't when that shot thumped in. There was a reaction, wasn't there?
Yes, there was. I think that was a little mark of respect from Buckley, dropping the hands. He just rattled him a bit. And then look at the jabs landed, 40 for Evatt and just 18 for Buckley, and those 40 have all been with a bit of power behind them.
You've got to measure it against the fact that he's in with a journeyman who's usually there just to survive, but this is a good effort from Evatt. He's doing nothing wrong, is he?
He's not, and it's the right sort of fight. It's to get him a bit of confidence, but you can't tell that much in this fight, because really, you know, the doubts about Evatt are when he gets hit, and we know that Buckley is not a puncher. And, you know, so we're not going to see if he's, you know, if he's solved any of his defensive problems.
Fourth and last round, they just swapped a few words there. Evatt called him Pete. I think these two have probably done a few sessions in the gym. Good left hand that from Evatt. He found a good angle for it. Notice any little changes about Evatt since he's gone over to Jerry Story?
Well, he's trying to use his jab more. I think, you know, that's the major one. But it's very difficult to change him that much. What they've got to try and do is tighten him up defensively.
Buckley comes out of his shell and gets aggressive for a few seconds. Fought so many champions along the way, seen it all, done it all.
Yes, I mean, he really does deserve a bit of credit. He's got an awful lot of losses, 117 and 151 fights, but it's been a, you know, pretty good career. He's been with some very good people.
Yeah. About, what is it, 48 away from his 200. It'll probably take him about four more years. shots, mixing up head and body shots in particular here from Evatt. Still looking for the stoppage in this final round.
I think Buckley will be quite glad this is just a four-round. Evatt is getting better and throwing more punches as the rounds have gone on.
Evatt looking pretty sharp.
Buckley's still got his pride, still trying to throw punches back.
Just wondering if Evatt might get in the ring again with Isaac Sedabuka. Try to wipe that from the record books. Would be quite interesting, that.
Yes, it would be. And also to wipe that from his mind if he could get a win over there. Just get rid of a couple of ghosts.
Buckley having his successes in this final round too, in which he's shown more ambition. But he's had to take quite a lot here from a charged up Richard Evatt, who looks as if he's prepared pretty well for this. There you go, come on, Sam. There you go. Get the bell any second now. No doubt about it, Evatt's won this and won it well. Victory for him, rehabilitation exercise successfully completed. But can he get back anywhere near the top, Glenn?
Well, we can't tell that much from this fight. What it is it's, you know, it's give him a bit of confidence, it's give him a win again. You know, but we'll see better when we see him in with an opponent who can be dangerous, because we need to see what he's like defensively.
Certainly wasn't coasting through that four-rounder, was he? He was looking to do quality work all the way.
I don't think that's in his nature. I think, you know, he'll always try his best, Richard Evatt. He'll always try and throw as many punches. He's an aggressive type.
And well outscoring Buckley, as you can see from the computer printout. Good success rate too for Evatt. I make him a 40-36 winner, that is, every round.
Our gentlemen, please. Referee Phil Kane has scored the contest. Buckley 36 points, Evatt 40 points. The winner, ladies and gentlemen, Richard Evatt. And the loser, please, gentlemen, Peter Buckley.